travel on. There's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand.
All right, everyone, welcome to another edition of the Neighborhood Watch. I'm Matt.
Pat.
I'm Abe.
I'm Brett.
All right, guys, 17. Episode 17.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, all we right. Made it this far. Perfect. So, we have some crazy situations on the docket. What we did last night, though, first is we had a murder mystery party, and there'll be some videos posted on YouTube about that, but we just want to let you know that we had a great time.
And a lot of fun.
What this whole thing is about is the community and friends and getting together and having a good time.
Neighbors.
So it's, we'll put some photos in the corner, yeah. And I was the murderer, so it was cool. So, I mean, that wasn't cool, but, you know, it was fun.
It was fun.
It was a lot of fun.
Yeah. Awesome, guys. So, how was your week?
Good. Yeah.
Good. Good.
Yeah. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Great. Just flew by.
I know. Another addition, man.
You got a Raiders win?
Raiders won. Yeah. That was a very exciting game Thursday. Thanks to Raider Nation.
Raider Nation.
I got a little disappointed, but, you know, we had a good season. My Yanks.
And
But on the other hand.
I am very happy. In fact, I'm going to game two on Wednesday, driving down Wednesday morning. 6-hour drive to go watch Dodgers versus the Astros.
Is that game one?
Game two.
Okay, perfect.
Yes.
Good.
So we had some an update from the San Ramon Valley Police Department. They put two drawings of the suspects that were are being, if they catch them, they'll be charged with lewd conduct. So we'll post that the pictures on the screen. What do you think about that, man?
That's yeah, good stuff, right? I think it's good to get the sketch drawings and the descriptions from the people that were approached by these individuals or individual. And we know it's an out-of-state license plate. They think Nevada. They've got a description of the car up there. So just keep your eyes out. This guy's popping up right around after school hours, you know, that 2:30 to 3:30 time frame. And
yeah, not good.
Sooner or later, they're going to get him.
Awesome. Very good news. That's a good tip. We'll put that on there soon. Also, there's a suspicious person driving around. The person that posted was concerned that they were working on their car. The guy was asking about, like, oh, that's kind of the model I want. You know, how much is it? And the guy said, it's not for sale. And he goes, oh, it's okay. I know where you live, so I'll come by later. And that kind of worried him. So I guess just be careful around your surroundings, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, the guy had like 40 grand he wanted to spend on a car he didn't even know about or something.
Yeah, so it's just...
But they think he might be casing, looking in the garage, looking for ways to get in the house, and, you know, just got to keep your eyes out.
Yeah. Don't be afraid to speak up.
Yeah.
Right.
What do you think about that?
I think when you see something, you got to speak up.
I think so, too.
Right? See something, say something.
There you go. I like that.
Right? You can always call the police and give them a description of what happened. There's a lot of weird stuff going on, though. Like, it wasn't even a full moon today. But these people, the posts today in particular.
Yeah, what about those posts? Do you have anything about those?
Well, let me see. Someone talked about there was, you know, this another report of a strange man.
Yes.
With really no description. Somebody said he could be nice, but then I think the description was he touched a
female's breast.
You know, I think that's so, classified as sexual assault.
Yeah, that could be, sexual assault. So if that happens, definitely call the police. We don't want, you know, you're walking your dog at night and someone come up and, you know, fondling your wife or your sister or something like that.
Anybody.
Right?
And, you know, so if you see something with this guy, just keep an eye out and report it.
Yeah.
Like, that's a common theme, report stuff.
Yeah, we're also seeing more... car break-ins, guys. It seems to be like almost like weekly we talk about car break-ins. What do we do with car break-ins? Or what you should do?
You don't leave stuff in your car that's visible. Yeah. Lock your doors. I mean, they're going to break in. I think some of these they might have broke through the window. But it's just things like leaving anything that's visible that somebody would want to grab.
So, yeah.
You know, and another thing, like, try to park your car. Like, if you do park in the driveway... there's some of these motion sensor floodlights that they have now with cameras in them. I know Ring makes one, like their doorbell. That might be a good option for you if you live in particularly in a dark area.
Yeah.
You know.
Just don't give them the opportunity to actually see something that they want. You know, if there's nothing in there to steal, they're probably going to move around and go to your neighbor that has something, you know.
Or get a large German Shepherd.
Yeah,
Brett.
That's right.
Yeah. Or
Works.
No break-in so far.
Awesome.
There's some activity on 680 and San Ramon Valley Boulevard this morning. Did you hear about that?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, there was a fatal truck accident. I don't know what happened. I read that the truck driver clipped another car and then went off into the side of the freeway, through the fence, maybe hit a tree. I did drive by the area about, I don't know, 11:30, and the truck was still there. The fire department, the police, were everything was roped off. The truck was just smashed and it was gone.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Just be careful driving out there, guys. Abe, you have something to talk about tonight, huh?
Yeah, I just wanted to give an update on Little League Baseball. So San Ramon signups are officially open. So get your child registered if you want them to play in the spring. I know sometimes people think, wow, it's pretty early, but there's actually tryouts. So if your child's over 7, they'll actually try out on the 4th, November 4th. Wow. So get signed up and get to the tryouts. Tryouts are important to be placed on a team. And then, you know, the league's always looking for coaches. So if anybody's interested, San Ramon Little League.
Do you get a is it free for the child if the parent coaches?
It's not free, but there's a you get a volunteer money back.
But, okay, so that's an initiative. And you know what? And my son plays basketball, and there were 31 kids turned away because they didn't have enough parents to coach. And, you know, just this is great that Abe's bringing this up, because if you have a child that wants to play baseball, it's important to know that, you know, parents are the ones that coach these leagues, right? And so if they, you know, if you can do it and you have the time, man, it changes the lives of these children. It gives them an opportunity to do something. Heck, you might even be, 20 years from now, watching a major leaguer.
Yeah. Right. Brett and I have coached. I coach girls lacrosse with San Ramon Raptors, ages 12 and under. And there's the ages 14 and under. We also have registration right now, but we're in the same situation. We need coaches. Yeah. So if you have a daughter that's new to the sport, want to try it, sign up, private message me. If you have questions about baseball, private message Abe, and we'll get your questions answered. But volunteers are what make these youth leagues happen, really.
Was there a website for that?
You get your website? You got your website?
Because we'll post it later, but I just... What, you said San Ramon Baseball, right?
Yeah.
Somebody did post it. I saw a posting.
Cool. We'll get it on there. We'll try to get it on there.
And we posted about lacrosse, too.
Yeah, cool. So, srbaseball.com.
Oh, that's easy. srbaseball.com.
Perfect.
Brad, do you have anything juicy?
I have nothing right now juicy. No, sorry.
Really? No.
Well, that's good, right?
Yeah.
Nothing, that means nothing's bad happening.
Yeah, no, everything's good.
That's it.
It's also Red Ribbon Week.
Oh,
I don't know if you guys were aware of that.
It's like DARE program for drugs, right?
Pretty much. Look at you. So it's a drug-free school celebration all week. So, obviously a lot of spirit days in the schools. You'll see red ribbons, and you'll see the solo cups and some of the fences at the schools and things like that.
That's cool.
So Tuesday's team up.
Red solo cups.
Red solo cups are cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's a song about that, I think.
Yeah.
This is the opposite of that, though. So this was, spirit days. Tuesday's team up against drugs. Wednesday is healthy habit days.
Nice.
Okay.
And then Thursday's sock it to drugs. So wear your foot socks.
Sock
nice. Love it.
Love. Hate. So,
get off.
And also, guys, I'm wearing this one more time because it's October, and in honor of Breast Cancer Awareness Month, we wanted to, you know, show that we care. So
keeping it going.
Mine's actually being washed this time.
Perfect.
Perfect. Yeah. Perfect. I'll wear mine next week. And we have Halloween coming up.
Yes.
Yeah.
What? So let us know what you're doing. Where do you want to go? Where are you going to take your kids trick-or-treating?
Got any big events?
Yeah. Maybe you'll run into the neighborhood watch. We should do a filming...
I think so.
Yeah, no, why we're doing the trick or treating?
Yeah.
Perfect. That would be a fun addition.
There is a post I saw about letting your neighbors know if you're going to give candy to kids. I think through the Nextdoor app, you can go to that post.
Yes, good point.
And make sure that your house is highlighted. That letting people know, hey, we're going to give out candy.
So what's cool is the person put, I'm doing. What's it called? gluten candy, gluten-free. And also you know, regular candy, so the kids know. So
wow.
High tech, man.
Used to be just about the peanut.
Right.
I want the king size, man. But I think, yeah, we'll be doing that, and that's a great idea, so you know what's safe, what house is safe that's giving out candy and stuff like that. So,
right.
Good times. All right, you guys have anything else, man?
I don't, man. It's kind of
a chill week. Chill. Just,
fall's coming in. And
holler out at the boys. You know, we're here for you. Neighborhood Watch.
We're here for you.
17th episode, guys. Let me just say one thing real quick. I wouldn't have wanted to do this with any other three guys, man. You guys are the bomb.
Awesome. Diggity. Appreciate that, brother.
Boom.
Man.
Boom. Boom. All right, man.
Fist pump. See you,
have
Sam,
a great night, and we'll see you later. Peace out.
Good week, people.